when the students start the quiz, they're invited to read through some background information, both included in that some special instructions for screen reader users. And you can see that it's pretty much text based and therefore lends itself to screen reading. If we have a look at a preview, we can see that we have 48 questions altogether. And if I just put in a couple of answers, I'll put in one correct answer and one wrong answer. And just submit. Click and continue, and then we get some general feedback, the score, the raw score, 1 out of 48, and some general feedback to have a look at the feedback and try again, and to have a look at the Math Centre site for further help, and also our phone number for math support. So I just scroll through the responses that appear, then you can see that for each wrong answer there's a sample solution, and also for each there's a vodcast of the solution. These don't play too well in this demo recording, so I've provided URLs separately for the vodcasts. So here was the correct answer that I put in, and here was the deliberately wrong answer. And again, we get a short explanation, also from time to time links to Math Centre and resources, and for each a vodcast. And the vodcast simply
to a simple algebraic expression to simplify it.
Because a quick
plus five
summary solution.
One set of brackets minus another set of brackets n minus two. So to progress with this,
if we look in the editing tab, this gives a flavour of what's involved in putting the quiz together. You can see that we have a question bank on the right here, with an option to create new questions and such like. And then over on the left we've got the actual questions that have been used in the quiz. So after each set of assessments, we can review the responses and look at rationalising the content of the quiz and so on.